If you follow me on Instagram, I've shared a lot since then, but I really feel like going into this show, this is where I'm supposed to be. That was like a test run, and I cannot tell you how much better I feel, how much better I look, and just how much I have improved from not doing Louisiana 3 weeks after the first one, and just taking the time to kind of recoup, get my mind right. I'll talk more about that later because there were a lot of changes that I made like internally that brought me here. So I honestly feel a lot happier. I don't know, man. I'm just thankful to be here, thankful for this opportunity, and I'm so excited to bring a whole new look and show you guys what I'm really made of. Like, I don't know. The whole Pro League is a different monster, and I feel like this is my real, like, okay, where do I measure up in the way of muscularity? Will I need to get leaner next time? Will I, you know, like, what do I need to do? This is test run number 2, and we may or may not be done after the show. It just depends on how I do, but I'm excited to be back home in Texas, and I have my, like, brothers coming. I have part of our team coming, Hustle Harder shout out, and yeah. So we're just gonna start out with a workout. This is my little circuit before, so this is the last workout. After this, the work is all done and all I have to do is eat. So I'll update you guys more on details and stuff later, but now let's go get this.
Yeah, it was a little off. Hold it, here again. Like, it's more like a circle. Yeah, that was, you had it there. Just,
okay, good. Perfect. I got it.
Yep, perfect. And you know that little shake of your hair works? Because you know what you do? Your head, you naturally tilt your hair to the right, your hair falls to your right, and it's annoying. It's because it makes your right shoulder also look smaller.
The middle part will make it better.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have more hair on both sides instead of on one side. Oh, we're going straight hair. I'm just gonna try it.
Soft.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Your front pose.
been to.
Well, we had clients there, and luckily, I mean, not really luckily, but they were busing them to a tent and having it outside.
Here again, right?
Elizabeth Power.
13.
So we're all checked in, got a little goodie bag, I'll show you guys in a little bit, but we're gonna go check out the stage and kind of see what's up. But there's also a cosplay convention right now, so you may see some weird stuff. Okay, so it's about 10:15 p.m. Friday night still, and I have all my food in for the day. That was a lot of food. I feel like I was just eating the entire day. So I'm definitely fuller. I look like I grew, so that's good. And I'm really curious to see how I wake up in the morning. I mean, I'm not really gonna be concerned about the scale or anything. I honestly may not look, just to, you know, stay out of my own head, because I've never had the goal of weighing more. I know what you're supposed to for glycogen fill out. You know, we won't get into that right now, but it's just, it's a lot. It's a lot of emotions, but I don't feel stressed. I'm actually very calm because, and I can talk about this more tomorrow, but like, I have like dropped all expectations for me, because I like for placings and stuff, because I have learned like pro bikini is like anybody, it's anybody's day type of thing. And it's like the look that works for you may not work for another physique. And you know, we're trying out this look. So last time we had a super like dry, tiny, depleted, and obviously that was told to be fuller. So I'm definitely fuller. Curious to see just how full I got. And I'm actually excited to look like I have muscle on stage now. So hopefully that's what we'll wake up like. But before I go to bed, first of all, I have two coats of Protan on. This is my, the Shoe Fairy sent me this little sleep shirt. It's like a gown thing. And then I got my pants because I didn't want the waistband to rub on my tan that was like still drying. I do the DIY tan, like myself. So that, oh, this happened. Don't know where that nail went. I looked for it, but it's fine. Whatever, I guess. It wouldn't be like show day if nothing like that happened for me. So in the morning we have our plan all written out. I'm gonna show you guys like every meal I eat. These are bigger meals, but they're no fiber, and I'll just leave the rest of that for tomorrow. But I have everything set out because it is an early morning. We'll go on stage around 11, so I need to get multiple meals in before. So we have everything's written down. I already portioned out all the meals that I need in the morning, and that's pretty much it. So tomorrow I'll also show you my show day bag and stuff like that, just to give some little tips and things you do need, things you don't need, stuff of that nature. So yeah, I have makeup at 7:20 in the morning, not too bad. And I'm gonna go try to get 7 hours of sleep, which is pretty normal for me. So that's it. Welcome to show day, Kerrigan 2.0. I'm super excited to show you. So, yeah. Morning, guys. It's show day. Game day. I feel amazing. We woke up at 109, yeah, 109. So last show day, I woke up at 104.
Dang.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah.
5 pounds, and there is no loss of detail. Everything just looks, sorry, I was jamming. Leave it. Yeah, but everything looks right. I'm super excited. Obviously, I'm doing straight hair today. So trying something new. I just have like, with my hair, my natural hair is already so like wide and like poofy. It kind of like covers up my back. And then obviously when you add in extensions, it makes it even thicker. So it was like basically hiding my width, my taper. Not that you're showing your back, but you do want that like that look of your lats in your back pose. So straightened my hair and we also cut it. So hopefully, just like basically a ratio, you know, it's showing more of my physique, therefore making me look bigger, which was the entire point of this like look, this show, like what we were going for. So I'm super excited. I feel like abnormally calm. But yeah.
Good. 11 and 16, switch please.
Let's go, number 10, up tall, good. Breathe it out.
Face the rear view.
Nice and easy. Let's go, Mayor.
Face front. Face forward for judges. Can you see your numbers, please?
Let's go, number 10. Up tight. Good.
Thank you, ladies. You can go ahead and file off stage.
Hey, Brett. Do you get a chance?
Yeah, for sure. We looked over and everything.
This was Kerrigan's pro debut. The other show, completely irrelevant. This truly, I mean, I couldn't be more proud. We'll go in detail. Y'all don't understand, well, you will, what it takes for Kerrigan to look the way she does. She is not an easy prep. Even when we do everything right, it's a freaking grind. And this was by far the hardest prep of her entire life. And to cut her placing in half, it's eerily similar to what we did for her pro card. She's only getting better. I always tell people that, you know, hustle harder, we get better. We don't just keep competing. I'm super pumped. like I said, husband, I love her to death. She's truly superwoman. The amount of business she manages with this, it's incredible. But as a coach, man, like, I can say this, we're gonna win shows. Like, it's inevitable, and we're coming. We're not there yet, but we're coming. But that's about it.
Six.
That's your best place in 10 days, right?
This is my second one, so yeah.
Okay, what was your first place in?
14. So I'm cutting it.
So, hey, that's a big jump, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Huge.
So, me and my wife were talking. You have a
favorite. All right, don't get the here today.
I wouldn't change much of anything except come in a little bit drier. Just a little bit.
In general, not just
general,
one place.
Everywhere. Just a little bit. Not too much. Just a little bit. The presentation's great, it looks good, it's exotic. I wouldn't overanalyze, overthink, and reinvent the whole wheel. Just come in a little tight. Little bit.
Do that. That's easy.
All right.
Last time it was fill out. This time,
little bit.
Find the happy medium.
Little bit. Just a little bit.
Thank you so much.
Okay, you're welcome.
Show is over. Me and Brandon will go over everything afterwards, just like we did the last video. But I just wanted to introduce you to my big bro. His girlfriend Emily. She's a keeper.
Hey,
I like her. She can be on my YouTube. But we're about to go eat a burger at Rodeo Goat. I am so excited for this. After Girl Power, we just had hibachi and it was like super late at night. And honestly, I never got that like fulfilling or feeling. So we're gonna have a burger, gonna have maybe some dessert, and then that's it for tonight. And then we're going out for gaming, drinking. Downbeat event. I'll talk about that in a second, but we're celebrating.
I think what you also need to realize is that social media is live. You're not going to make a ton of money on $20,000.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm saying there's
money.
So good. Somewhere I can put it. Thank you.
Hi, guys. So it is about a month post show, a little over a month, and we'll get into this in a minute, but we did a lot of stuff with our friends. We went on our honeymoon. We're back. We have kind of our lives back together. And I just wanted to take this time to finish this video and reflect on this season. So I want to know.
Whole season?
This is the end of the season video. So I just want to know from a coach, not a husband standpoint, what you thought, and then I'll say my thoughts at the end.
The entire season?
The entire season. Okay, wait, let's start with Dallas first.
Dallas was a success because we made improvement. I kind of used like the pro debut as like the baseline for like Kerrigan's competing career. Kind of like starts over when you're a pro. So it's not like we were trying to win, but of course we wanted to. So
I feel like you always win.
Yeah, but you get what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. It's not like you had to do better than winning junior nats. So going from 14th to 7th is really nice because if for some odd reason Kerrigan does the one show where the first call out was 4 instead of 7.
That's first call outs.
Yeah, so in theory she went from second call outs to first call outs.
You can't
say that, but technically that's what happened.
And, first call outs is basically the goal for going into Dallas.
And first call outs is always 7 or 8. It's almost always 8.
And then in the show is 4.
And the show is 4. And so, but anyway, it doesn't matter. It was great.
I feel like that physique was like picked up off the floor from Girl Power.
Yeah, I mean, the good part about, when you're competing is actually if things don't go as planned and then actually getting better, it's a lot of people say they're going to get better. And in reality, it's just they 4 weeks pass and they get a little bit leaner. That was not, we had a whole different job. Yeah, we had a whole different thing to accomplish and we did it. In Dallas, did we push it a little bit? Probably, but that was we agreed that we didn't care at that point. It was gonna.
I mean, they asked for Fuller, and literally the only thing you can do in the sport is listen to your feedback and follow.
Yeah, through. And so.
So that's.
Well, I wasn't finished yet. So.
Okay, I'm sorry. I can
come. But and that's what we did. They wanted Fuller, so we ate more. She weighed like almost 5 pounds heavier, and it was a really good look. Is it her best look? No, but we're getting there, which
but
is.
But I wouldn't say Girl Power is better.
No, I'm not. Let me finish. Gosh, can you, anyways, her best look is probably like, I would say about 2 pounds less than what Dallas was. That kind of conditioning with that fullness. And, mm-hmm. You know, hitting that on your first or second try is it's kind of laughable as a, you know, as a competitor. We're gonna keep doing this, you know, that's trial and error. So I think it was successful. I think it sets her up perfectly for next year to potentially the goal will be to be top five. I mean, of course we want to win a show, but she's in the, moving in the right direction. And now we know where she's too depleted, and then now we know where she's slightly a little bit too full. We can kind of work for in the middle. And we also have weights, which is huge because this prep was a lot different than the past, and we kind of know where she needs to be. And yeah, it's it was successful.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna throw that off by getting boobs.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So you won't really know, but you'll know.
Yeah, but I think you said they weigh like 2 pounds or something.
Yeah, we're gonna. You're gonna figure out how much those things weigh. But anyway, I'll get into that as well on another video, most likely. But yeah, like my thoughts, I was extremely happy with Dallas, honestly. I don't remember what I said in this video. Obviously, the video y'all just watched. But I went into Dallas, like, I like had no expectations for myself. Honestly, I think going into Girl Power, I stressed myself out so bad. Like, not only was my body stressed, but like my mind was so stressed because I wanted to like, I wanted to do like,
no,
that's really
hair.
Great hair. I wanted to like of course I always want to do well, but I'm like, I want to do so well and be it like just absolutely blow everything out of the water, everything be perfect. And going into Dallas, I kind of dropped those expectations and I'm like, dude, you're doing the best you can and it's gonna pay off. And that's pretty much like, I felt so calm. I didn't even feel like going into peak week, I didn't even feel like I was in peak week. I was just like, I was straight chilling, honestly.
That's going off what she said, though. One thing I would change was we shouldn't have done Girl Power. It was an impulsive decision. Kerrigan really wanted to do that show. And it basically, we should have kept dieting for 4 to 6 weeks. And we would have basically been able to get that conditioning and be super full with the time. And Girl Power, when we decided we were 2 weeks out, it was like, good God.
I mean, yeah. I'll put the pictures right here. Like, this was the 2 weeks out. And
it was
then
a massive change.
Yeah, it was a very, very big change, especially
to my
We're
adding, like, 10-minute increments of cardio, like, every 3 days. It was getting crazy. Because we just do it, and it was great. But now we know, we also, what were we, 16 to 18 weeks?
That was 17 weeks.
Yeah, we're going to probably do 20 now, no matter what. She won't hit a stage until she's 20 weeks of dieting.
Yeah.
It's just, it's,
even then, like, don't be like the day I announce I start prep, like, oh, let's wish it was 20 weeks out. Like, no.
Yeah, we're past that.
You know, it's funny because we always said, like, I wouldn't compete until I'm ready. I wouldn't compete until I'm ready. But, like, when we got down to that 2 weeks, I was like, yeah, I'll be ready. You know, like, I legitimately thought.
I think you got excited. You just wanted.
Well, you did too.
Yeah, but I think you too, as a competitor, you wanted a date. Because it gets weird.
Oh, I love deadlines.
Yeah, but we will do a deadline more in the future, but we'll probably be. I would say we'd be about like maybe a 2 pounds closer.
Yeah, instead of having we need to be closer.
Exactly. Because sure. that made us, it did not. Wait, hold on. It,
please don't. what it
did was it made us have to push through peak week, whereas.
To Wednesday, right?
She was
yeah, for
kind
power.
Of when. It was honestly like Thursday.
Yeah, because we did like basically like a refeed into
yeah,
the show.
Yeah, but and now, whereas Dallas, we started feeding on Sunday.
Which I will say, the Dallas peak week was different than any peak week I've ever done. Like,
yeah, but
I've never really gotten to
that's just because,
peak week
but
because I've never been.
That's because
lean.
We've always pushed. Yeah,
I've never been lean.
That, yeah, honestly, you can blame that on me, I guess. But
I mean, I wouldn't say that.
I'm just saying that you traditionally should start loading. Or I get the whole backloading is outdated. It is backloading is so popular because bodybuilders have to make weight, so you don't really get to load until a couple days before. But if you're really ready, you can just, you know, do a linear load and start bringing carbs back in or higher by like Sunday, Monday, and it's easy. It's just Kerrigan.
And
I'm just being honest, like as I learn more as a coach, you know, I prefer a linear load for bikini now. If you asked me that like 3 years ago, I would have, I'm bodybuilding, let's do Thursday and Friday, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just because the fullness you get with bikini, it's such a subtle change, except for Kerrigan's crazy 6 weeks, but it's usually subtle. So it's not like you need any like dramatic low, you know, like to 400% carbs, you know?
Yeah. So I will say going into Dallas, like the 6 weeks between shows, that was obviously like a big change, if you guys saw on Instagram and everything. So I think that time period stressed my body out a little bit more than it should have. Personally, like on the linear load and everything, like by the end of the day, like when I did have all the food in, which I should or I will be able to handle more food when my body's not as stressed, but by the end of the day when I had all my food in, I felt very like.
Yeah, but you're stressing.
No, I know. My body was stressing. Yeah. My mind wasn't. But that actually is shown in blood work, which I posted today. Right after Dallas, I got blood work done, and I was like, all right. So the plan was to go 3 more weeks to Republic of Texas. That would have been my last show of the year. I literally ordered another suit. I was ready to go, and that check-in day, I got my blood work back because I was like, man, something's off. So I just feel so heavy, and something's off. I gotta go see what it is. And my cortisol came back the highest it's ever been. It was 28.3 or something. And I literally looked at that blood work, and I turned around to Brandon, and I was like, hey, I think we're done. Like, yeah, we need to be done.
And I think
for my health.
I think a big part on why it was so stressful. And this is funny. This is like, because someone asked about me being your coach, and this is a perfect example of how it can backfire. Being honest, yeah. The reason that Dallas was so hard was because Kerrigan put on fat in between.
100%.
The 3 weeks after, 3 weeks after Girl Power was.
It was a diet break, but I can honestly say I was not perfect.
We ate out like it was not, and there were times where I was her husband. No, there were times where I was being nice to her, and I shouldn't have been nice. No,
honestly, you shouldn't have been nice. I'm not saying it's your fault.
But that's why I said this is the dynamic.
No, I even like went out for my best friend's birthday.
Anyone else, I would have.
I didn't drink.
Anyone else, any other client, I would have been absolutely not. But when you see your wife sad. And hungry, but this was that.
My mom's over here trying to feed me cookies.
Yeah, it wasn't a lot. It wasn't a lot, but what made it hard was usually after a show, if you have 6 weeks in between, you're gonna have a diet break or whatever a week and everything. You're not gonna gain any fat. You're gonna get some fullness, some water, but you're not gonna gain any fat. No, Kerrigan, we have the pictures to prove it. I knew when we were around 3 weeks out of Dallas, we were like, well, shit, we got some work to do. And so,
I was like. 21 days.
When you're 18 or 20 weeks into prep and your hormones, let's be honest, thyroid and everything is down regulated and you gotta lose the fat that you lost a month ago. Oh that was extremes we won't talk about, but it was but the thing is, it's just we pulled it together.
I did pull it together enough, but you can't beat the stress that you put on your body by doing that.
Exactly. So and it's funny because if you take that away. And if you take a look at two things, take away Girl Power setting that show, and then take away that fat that we had, whatever. Kerrigan for sure would have ended her season at Republic of Texas. Easily could have gotten that far. It's just, live and you learn, that's about it.
Like he said, I think the big factor there is the hardest part is having my husband as my coach. Like, he wants me to be happy. I was not happy. Like, I can control my emotions, but I was not the same person.
And I'll say one of a trait that is interesting with me is, we're gonna get better. I need to learn to say no, because then I'll almost get mad at her because I'm the one that let it happen.
Well, I can also tell you, remember you were dieting with me, and then that was in your weird little diet between the time you hired Matt.
Oh.
And when you ended your cut.
Oh, when I was kind of like lost.
You were doing like push-up snack binges type of
I wasn't behavior. Binging. Hey, Brandon Guillen is not binge, okay? Don't ever say
there
that.
There was one night.
There was, okay. No, I. But anyway, there's.
Hey, I told him, I was like, he did all of that without a coach. And I told him, I was like, I could never do that. Do what you did. What did you lose, like 20 pounds?
20 pounds in 12 weeks.
Yeah, there's no way in hell I could do that. So I'm not talking crap, but like.
But that's why everybody keeps telling us, like, because apparently I'm gonna compete again. But ever compete again as a couple, oh my gosh. I think we talked about it, like, and we'll try and do it separately. And then if God's willing, we meet at the Olympia. I'm not gonna get there, she will. But I don't know if we'll ever prep together, because that shit will be crazy.
Honestly, if we prep together and you're my coach?
No, it's because we don't.
No.
It's the client load too. Like,
it's our work.
The only time we did in the past, it was way long ago. That was before we even merged businesses, and our client load is probably like, what, a third of it is now? And it just doesn't make sense. Will we maybe do it? The only way it might work would be if Kerrigan was tail end, and then in my Brandon fashion way of dieting, I just sprint for like 8 weeks, because if I tell Matt, I know he can get me there. And so it's just like 8 weeks of hell. And then we get to the end goal.
8 weeks at each other's throats. Yeah. Or 8 weeks of just not speaking.
But you know, I will say, this is funny, even though we're getting off topic.
It's fine.
I do not stress while dieting, ever. Like, I know. No, wait, listen though.
Mr. Power of cardio.
Let me finish. So I don't stress. I do what I'm told, and it'll work out. It's fine. And I admit that, yeah, I...
Maybe I should pay you. No, it helps.
Anyway, bear in mind... So, but I will say I do stress about Kerrigan. So I'm wondering if
he stresses before I do.
Yeah, no, even with clients, I'm very chill. I know what we're going to do. I know even peak week, I don't stress on the day of the show. But Kerrigan's the only one, like, my heart will start racing. I'll get anxious.
Towards the end of prep, I remember I was like, I don't want to talk about my prep with you anymore. I don't want to tell you how I'm feeling outside of check-ins. Like,
yeah.
I don't want to talk.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to influence your decisions.
Yeah, but I'll get to that, though. But mm-hmm. I was going to say is that if we prep together, I think for the first time in my life, I would actually stress to where it would stop progress. And I wouldn't diet like I usually do, where I'm mm-hmm. pretty...
And then you'd be even more stressed.
Then I'd get angry because that's just not right, yeah.
Your last prep was like textbook, like...
Yeah, no, it was... They were both like 10
linear,
weeks.
Basically.
Yeah, it's pretty... I know what...
He's a crazy dieter. I can't wait for y'all to see that. Maybe this will not be my YouTube anymore. It may be in Brandon's YouTube.
I'll document it because, yeah, I'm like I said, in my 12-week 20 pounds, I changed my diet twice.
Except for that one time he pulled fats and just got
mean. Oh, yeah.
He pulled fats and just got mean.
That was a bad decision. Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I need you right now.
Yeah, I was just having fun. But what were we just talking
That's
about,
super
though?
Fun.
Oh, but no, what she was saying is we stopped talking about her prep because mm-hmm. When you coach people online, the distance, or not online, even just in general, that was just a term, but when the distance you have with the person is very good because yeah.
You shouldn't be their best friend.
Yeah, you are. It takes emotion out of it and it lets you think with your gut and make the right call, which is almost always your gut. So Kerrigan and I, as we're getting close, remember we're seeing each other maybe. She's doing so much cardio in our schedule. We
stopped watching our shows.
Yeah, we believe it. We don't work out at the same time. Yeah. We do work at the same time, but we work in different rooms. Like, we're weird, yeah.
We were just like roommates.
Yeah, and so when we sat down, it was obviously there's not a lot to talk about, but we stopped talking about our prep because I was getting indecisive. Like, and I know that's not me as a coach. And,
it's not you.
And then I coach her on WhatsApp, just like everybody else.
Yeah,
she's not special. Yeah, she's checking. But
there's,
I would go back and I'm looking at me and I'm just analyzing everything so much. And I was like, dude, I am thinking way too much. And then she was just like, that was honestly where we hit a point where you were really like, should you coach me? Remember? Yeah, yeah. And obviously we're all angry, we're low food. And yeah, it was just Kerrigan was like, you need to just coach me and not like, and I was like, I literally told her, I was like,
give me numbers.
Yeah, and I told her, I was like, I don't, and yeah, that too. I was like, I do not want to hear, honestly, this sounds terrible and this is not how we treat people. But I told her, I was like, I do not want to hear your opinion about anything I do.
No, I said I didn't want to give it to you.
Yeah, I was like, do exactly what I say, even if you think it is completely wrong.
That's what I did.
Yeah, and it worked out.
And I was like, yeah,
and
just
you know,
because we're both coaches.
Yeah, and the thing,
and it's like, maybe I would do something slightly different. We mainly think the same.
And you know what? I take back about what I said at Dallas, though. Dallas, her, I think one day out would have been
one
peak.
One day out was disgusting.
Peak. Like, I think that was...
I needed, like, one day
less. You know what I'm talking about? Because that's when we posted...
Is she in the gym?
No, but... Yeah, but that was... Those lighting... That lighting...
Was tight.
Dude, she looked incredible. And she still had the real, like... We lost the time. It wasn't even... I don't know what to say if it was water. Because we pushed her
food up. So, that picture... And I'll put it right here. That picture that I posted...
You need to post a check-in one.
I'll post both.
That was peak right
so
there.
So, I'll post a check-in one with natural lighting. And then it'll be a collage with the down lighting picture that we took in the posing room at Destination Dallas. Remember, down lighting
super,
is really cool to look at,
and
but it makes you look a little softer.
No, inflammation,
yes.
Water, I mean everything. And like I said, but the look, it was really...
That next morning.
Kerrigan really, I know Kerrigan, honestly, we've realized, I want to say before stage, two-ish meals and right around like 40 ounces of water,
yeah,
give or take,
about
40.
The coffee.
Yeah, about 40 ounces of water. Remember, that's almost a half a gallon. People do think that's not a lot. Yeah, it sometimes gets to 50 if the show gets longer or whatever. But yeah, and it's cool because Dallas was cool. I actually prefer that we pushed it. Because if we would have gone in flat, then it's like, okay, we improved a little bit, but no, we went like, I mean, from here, like both sides of the spectrum. We went, so now we know exactly
where we just need to find the happy middle. Yeah. Because I would say like some of the like stage videos from Dallas and stuff, I'm like, dude, why does your waist look not it wasn't bad. It was just
it
not
wasn't
my
bad
waist.
Because it wasn't bad though, because
I was like, guys, when I told you, I think I said in the last video, I was like, if I am still too small, I will call my season there rather than Republic of Texas. And, I mean, nobody said I was too small, but I was full on lat spread up there. Like, and I don't recommend that to everyone.
I mean, whenever I saw her on stage, we saw a little bit of, we could see the
little,
there
was fat there.
No, well, little bit of fat and water because you had so many carbs. Yeah, we pushed this higher than she's ever been. And
my glutes are bigger, so they still look good, but I was not conditioned to where I should have placed
The cool part about this, no. This is what I guess the last thing I'll say about the whole thing. I don't know if you want to talk more, but
go for it.
Is that we know that we can diet Kerrigan down to the conditioning needed for bikini. That was always in the past. We didn't know junior nats, we got to, what was it, 2 hours in 130, 2 and 10 minutes.
2 and 10 minutes.
And we were like, damn, is there anything?
For junior nats.
That's for junior nats, right? And we're like, damn, is this even possible for Kerrigan? Like, and we know it's possible, but is it
going to... My butt was still jiggling that.
Yeah, is it going to be worth it for things? So now we know that, because Girl Power and everything, they all said conditioning. Remember Sandy and what's her other, Becky, mm-hmm. Two very important judges. They literally said conditioning was awesome. So we did a condition. We messed up on the fullness fine. That's okay, you mess up sometimes. We know in Dallas, we know how to push it now and how we can really transform her look to make her appear way bigger on stage. So that whole like-
That was the goal, make me appear.
Yeah, bigger. Yeah, exactly.
It wasn't necessarily bigger.
Exactly, so now that we have the beauty of bodybuilding, which is what? An off-season. The greatest thing in this sport. It basically, there is no reason in any world for us to not bring like the, oh my God, Kerrigan's in content to win a show physique the next time she competes. I'm not saying she's like, I'm just talking at her coach. We know we can hit the conditioning. It's actually going to be easier to hit the conditioning because she's going to have more muscle. And we've already decided we're adding it everywhere. Like,
I said this on Instagram. Yeah, we can go. I want to know that.
I said this on Instagram,
but between when I won my pro card and Girl Power, my feedback from Junior Nats was not to let your glutes grow anymore and come in a hair tighter. Therefore, I did not grow in that off season. I did not.
Oh, well, absolutely not. Of course, we weren't even trying.
No, exactly. Yeah. I was just maintaining. I never got very far away from stage weight. I think it was 7 pounds.
That's, no,
I never let myself get to the point.
For anybody who's wondering, this is for people, you have to hit body highs to gain like a legitimate
outfit. I mean,
anyone who tells you that you can, yes, keeping it lean is good for a little bit, but if every one of your off seasons ends at 115, you're not gonna add a lot of tissue.
Yeah.
And just like I said, it's
now,
cool.
Can I add something?
Yeah.
Now I did grow in prep. I am not a natural athlete, therefore I did grow in prep.
It's more
I just want to be transparent about that. It was
recomposition. It's recomposition.
Because if you look at my starting prep pictures and my ending, that's only an 8 pound difference.
Let me edit that. She grew into junior nats. That was the first time. First exposure with PEDs, you're going to actually grow while losing fat.
It's like newbie games.
Exactly. But in this pro debut, no, she recomp. That's it.
Okay.
Just to be as accurate as possible.
No, I like that. Yeah. That makes more sense.
But I think going off now, when we saw these girls backstage, I didn't know these bikini girls had better arms than me. And Kerrigan doesn't really... Kerrigan doesn't have arms. We both have no triceps. But, dude, seriously, it's terrible. It's horrible. Anyway, I'm very good at looking at bodies and having... And you remember, she's 5'1 and a half. I think the goal is to add I'm gonna go with 3 to 4 pounds of muscle.
Oh, yeah.
3 to 4 pounds of tissue. Three to 4 pounds of tissue.
On somebody 5'1", like.
Bruh. 3 to 4 pounds of tissue. Yeah. I can do that shit in my sleep. No, but anyway. That's what we love. That's why I only compete twice, once every decade.
Next time he'll be in his 30s.
Yes. Oh my God. You're right. What's up? Anyway.
Okay, stop. No. Last time he just competed was in
2017.
Anyway,
we're gonna finally. It'll be easier to hit condition because she's gonna have more muscle. The muscle's literally gonna be more apparent. It's freaking. That is. Everybody knows that. Okay. And then knowing that we can hit it and we're not gonna have to, you know, kill the poor girl is a great thing. Now we have a formula for fullness. That was our first time loading from, obviously, which is how we traditionally load people, but it's the first time that Karen got to experience that much food. We know that, in theory, probably keep it a little bit in it, you know, start a little bit slower, but if we know she can handle 7 days of food and peak, we can, it's just, it's gonna be the recipe for a good look. I think this debut, a lot of people, it's funny because she, in reality, was super successful. Like of course you have those random people that debuts are great, but I think it's gonna be really fun to see. We're gonna do better than seventh place next time.
I'll just come out and be transparent about that. Like, if I don't get, honestly, top five, I missed.
Yeah, no, there's no.
Now, if I get beat, that's okay. I'll just go get better. But like,
I'm seeing. These, yeah, it was cool too. It was cool to see the top Olympian girls in person and really see and get a good idea. Like, okay, I get it now. The reality is, I know that those girls are not improving, but they shouldn't because they're being rewarded.
They're already.
Yeah, they're there.
They're there.
And now I know what it takes to get there. And Kerrigan will be there. Kerrigan will be there in 8 months. Like that's just in.
Maybe a little fluffy, but.
But yeah, her breast. Augmentation. The breast, her tits, and implants is going to take some of that timeline,
but we don't need 12 months.
I think we need a solid and a surplus 8. And when's the last time? The last time it was like, you look like a different person. Do you remember
when the last time I actually tried to grow?
Yeah.
When I got up to like 132.
Yeah, we're not going to
132. I'm not pushing it though.
I think though, realistically, I think she's going to, I think we're going to get to, no, but you say that.
That timeline was, okay, with more muscle, yes, but I will never be that body composition at 132.
No, but I think you're going to get close to 130.
I agree.
That's what's going to be necessary.
Yeah, I know where I am right now.
And see, again, then our prep's probably going to end up being 24 weeks, you know? Give or take.
But I'm not in a hurry at all.
Mm-mm. No, we don't.
Because you're good now?
Yeah.
I'm just writing this video here, but I'm not in a hurry for this. After Girl Power, I got a lot of online criticism. I had to like remind myself like why I was doing this. I went back and proved myself, at least to myself, in Dallas. And now I've seen exactly like where I level up, what I need to do. And I've seen also my reality of how hard or how much, I won't say I work harder than anybody. I'll say I have to work more, meaning maybe more cardio, maybe less food like that, or for longer than a lot of the other girls that I'm going against now, which is just a fact of me. Not every athlete is, you know, as genetically gifted as some of the people I'm going against. And I can honestly say I'm not genetically gifted in that department at all.
Of course. Yeah. No, I mean,
at all.
Like, you, it's funny because I know how I like relate. Like, I diet and like my thyroid doesn't even get impacted. Like it's crazy.
I mean, I will say, judging on blood work, yay, my thyroid is very resilient, but it's never a optimally functioning thyroid. I would just say it's a little below average type of thing. But I am going to, and I've already had a really good start to this. I'll talk about this in another video, but I've had a really, it was a fast start to adding adipose tissue. That was my fault. Once again, we went out with friends. We went on a honeymoon. We did all of this stuff, right?
Yeah.
But I have held steady at the same exact weight, you know, just floating half a pound up and down for 2.5 weeks now. And I am eating about 210 carbs, 130 protein, and 45 to 50 fat, typically. So, and a free meal a week. So I'm happy with how this started, and my big goal for this year, the second half of this year, is to actually, you know, keep that under control, because in the past I would like maybe gain a little too much weight, go back down to macros, like kind of like bounce back and forth. But you know, if I just actually keep my head in the game, maybe I'll be able to start prep next time eating a bit more food and see more progress.
And if you have to put on any type of tissue at all in between your seasons, there is no season. You have to keep bodybuilding, or else it is going to,
Yeah, you're not gonna just live your life and put on 2 pounds of muscle. It's not gonna happen.
No,
especially
if you're a woman too. I know. Yeah. Like, I mean, even no enhance too. Like, that shit works for a couple years, and then I'm telling you, there's a reason that everybody gets stuck in that journey to going pro is because they don't train hard and they don't do it year round. Like, it sucks. And so, well, Kerrigan's. I mean, it's cool because I'm on plan now. I haven't been on plan in years.
It is very nice to have you on plan.
Before. Yeah, and yeah, it, like I said, it's off season, but she has to. We'll start. You know, getting, and now that our honeymoon's over and everything's got
your
all
cortisol's
the, yeah, we'll start getting there. But like I said, we'll get like labs again just for health purposes. Probably.
Oh, another, I'll just keep them on.
Another 4 to 6 weeks, and then but off yeah, to the races. I mean, it depends.
I'm
if
off of
yeah,
everything.
We're
kind of just in this little
zero
waiting period.
Well, it's just the main thing though is timing the yeah, it's a health phase. You know, it's just waiting for everything to get to getting in a normal level does not mean you're ready to start pushing food, and you know, it's you need to be optimal, and that's all we're doing. It's
yeah,
just it'll probably, I think, give it, it's only been what, a month?
It's been 5 weeks yesterday.
Yeah, I mean, 8 to 12 weeks generally. It's, I mean, honestly, no, that's 8 to 12 weeks if you died for like 12 to 16. She died for what,
27.
So I would say we'll probably be in the clear 12 to 16.
Yeah,
and 12 would be,
I would say so.
12 would be remarkable. Actually, I don't think 12 is gonna happen.
I was, not like all the traveling and stuff we're doing.
No, I think it's gonna be about, excuse me, I think it might be 16 weeks, and then we're gonna kind of go yeah, around her breast augmentation.
So when I get that consultation at the end of August, I will then set a surgery date. And from there, I'm going to work back and work forward on basically dividing up the weeks until the next target show, you know, ideal show date.
Yeah, I think we've talked about it.
So
an hour video.
It's fine. Yeah. So I can like, you know, do that the correct way and stay on plan. So that was a lot. Thank you guys for watching. Sorry this season didn't have a ton of videos. I was going through it this season, so hopefully I can manage
hopefully
that better next
someone
year. Yeah, I put on my story today. Like, we're looking for somebody. There's a lot of people moving to Alphaland. There's a lot of opportunity here. We're looking for somebody that can be basically our person.
Everything. Video it.
Reels.
Content.
Yeah, just everything. So honestly, if you see this and you're like, I would move to Houston for that, go ahead and send me an email. My description.
Hustle hard, just going to the moon. Look at my exponential growth. Like the sorority girls.
What? All right. So thank you guys for watching. As always, momentum is a cool title for this because I feel like I still do have momentum and I'm going to keep it going in this off season. So I don't want to get all cheesy now, I've talked enough, but again, thank you for watching, and
season 3 is going to be Zero Dark 30.
Season 3, Zero Dark 30.
I'm just kidding.
You want to do it?
No, it's good? Fine. No, okay, it's great. All you.